for war and management, and also to formulate and oversee implementation of the laws and policies in place, create efficiency for trade facilitation and the movement of people. And therefore, the question that lingers is how do we move this coordination, and I see that is the theme of this conference, towards integration. There are, of course, a number of challenges in this endeavor to coordinate border management and control programs. And the first one is the changing nature and the changing definition of the border. As you're aware, ladies and gentlemen, delegates, the border is the place where countries exercise their territorial control and jurisdiction. It is the place where compliance to the country's security, health, agriculture, trade, and other...
Identify and respond to threats that are of hybrid nature, including cross-border and transnational organized crime. And in this regard, we are progressively reducing the use of FOID travel documents, illegal migration, human trafficking, smuggling of weapons, trafficking of narcotics, and money laundering, among other crimes. Third is that we have significantly improved clearance of persons at our points of entry and exit, and also increased the volume of trade, which stands to the smooth movement of people and goods across our borders. At the beginning of this year, of course, we introduced the visa-free regime, and also, of course, we are training our frontline border officers through a recently introduced curriculum, which is known as the Kenya Coordinated Border Management Program. Then regional integration to harmonize border control policies, and I'm happy that today our PS in charge of ESC and our colleague from Tanzania in charge of trade are all here, and they're progressively engaging within that framework to ensure that the ESC actually works for the good of all its citizens. Now, we cannot, of course, afford to be comfortable as transnational crime, terrorism, and other illicit activities do not know borders and boundaries, and they thrive on the absence of cooperation, exploiting the vulnerabilities whenever they arise. And now, more than ever, we are obligated to perceive our points of entry and exit systems through the national security lens. Let us therefore seize this conference to exchange ideas, share best practices, and also forge new partnerships. Through dialogue, innovation, and a shared sense of purpose, we can overcome these challenges and chart a course
of security. So even as we struggle with the physical border, we need to increasingly look at how we coordinate our activities to protect our virtual borders. The second challenge, of course, is how to manage non-intentional risks, because traditionally the border control management has been focused on intentional risks, where people who are either criminals or dealing with illicit goods want to access the territory unlawfully against the law. But we have cases of non-intentional risks of people who pose a risk to the country through inadvertent and unknowing, unknown to them. And this is more so in areas like biosecurity, where people access the territory, but they are already exposed.